Good afternoon to one and all. I'm R.V. Kiran, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Chebrol Engineering College. Today, in this video lecture, I'm going to explain about you some of the inversions of kinematic chain. And this is my fifth video lecture regarding to the subject, kinematics of machinery. In the earlier classes, we have discussed about the kinematic pairs and classification of the kinematic pairs. And we have also discussed about what is a kinematic chain also. So first of all, we use it to define the inversion of a kinematic chain. So we use it to define what is an inversion of a kinematic chain. So first of all, we used to see that. So for a machine, the chains come from the kinematic pair, and according to the degrees of freedom as per Kurzweil criterion, we come to the kinematic chain. Then we go to the mechanism and a machine is assembled there. So this is the basic process in the assembling of a machine. First of all, we used to see what is an inversion of a mechanism. So the method of obtaining different mechanisms by fixing the different links in a kinematic chain is called as inversion of the mechanism. So we used to obtain different mechanisms. So the method of obtaining these different mechanisms by changing the fixed link. So accordingly, there is no constant fixed link in every mechanism. So we are going to change this in every mechanism. So that is going to be a very different fixed link. So that type of method he obtained is called as inversion of a mechanism. So that type of mechanism is said to be an inversion of the mechanism. So that is called as an inversion. So in the slider crank mechanism, there are four links. So we are fixing the first link, that is the base, that is called as fixed link. And second link, it is the crank. And third link, it is the connecting rod. And last one, it is the slider. But coming to the inversion, the fixed link may change from base to the crank or coupling connecting rod. Or the slider, so we can change the fixed link in the given mechanism. So that type of elements can be done in the inversions. So that is known as the inversion of a mechanism. So in the kinematic chain, there are different types of inversions are there. So first one is the four bar chain mechanism. Second one is the inversion of slider crank mechanism. And third one and last one is the inversion of double slider crank chain mechanism. So these are the three different types of inversions in the kinematic chain. So in these, in each category, there is a subcategory of mechanisms we use to study in this kinematic chain. So first one is the four bar chain. So in the four bar chain, we used to know that there are only four links. So first link is the fixed link here. You can see it in the picture also. And second link is the crank. And third link is the connecting rod. And last one is the oscillator. So this is a four bar chain mechanism. And here first link is the fixed link. So here we are indicating the shortest link and the longest link for satisfying the Grubler's criterion. So the sum of the shortest link and the longest link is less than or equal to the remaining two links. So that is the condition for the Grubler's criterion. And coming to the second diagram, the fixed link is changed from the first link to the connecting rod. So you can see it in the picture also. So it is changed from fixed link to the connecting electrode, that is the longest link. So it is indicated as L there. So the longest link has been indicated as the fixed link. So this type of changes occurs in the inversions of the four bar chain mechanism. So the links does not change here, the only fixed link. So the position of the fixed link is the changing here. So that is the only difference occur in the four bar chain mechanism. So coming to the inversions of four bar chain mechanism, we have different types of mechanisms here. So first one is the beam engine, second one is the coupled locomotive of the wheels, third one is the Watt's indicator mechanism, and fourth one is the pantograph, and fifth one is the Ackermann's mechanism. Last one is the Ackermann's mechanism. In the first unit itself, we have the first three mechanisms, that is the beam engine, coupled locomotive of a coupled rod of a locomotive, that is called coupled automotive wheels, and third one is the Watt's indicator mechanism. So these are the three main mechanisms in the inversion of four bar chain, which will be evaluated in the first thing, or which will be explained in the first unit itself. So first of all, we go to the beam engine. So the first inversion is the beam engine here, so it is called as first inversion. And in the second inversion, it goes to the coupled rod of a locomotive. And in the third inversion, it goes to the first indicator mechanism, that is Watt's indicator mechanism. Second one is the pantograph, and third one is the Ackermann's steering mechanism. But in the first unit, we have only three mechanisms, that is beam engine, coupled rod of a locomotive, and Watt's indicator mechanism. So these are the three mechanisms we have in the syllabus for the first unit. And the remaining two mechanisms is in the second unit only. So that lies in the second unit. So first one, it is the beam engine. That is the inversion of a four bar chain. So you can see it in the picture. There are four links. First one is the fixed link here. First one is the fixed link, second one is the crank, third one is the connecting rod, and the fourth one is the lever. So this is the base of the beam engine here. So we are taking the base as the fixed link, and next we have connected a crank there, a crank or a disc we have connected to a fixed point there. So it is rotating in the clockwise direction. So to the crank we are connecting a connecting rod from the lever. So this is the lever position here. So lever ante oka kaata laga untadamma, so manaki ee kooragayali kaata untadu sara ala untadi kaata. So danni lever antunnam ikkada. So fourth link is the lever here. So it is connected to the connecting rod, link is connected to the one end of the lever. Here it is in the left position, so we can take it in the right position also. So when the crank rotates in the clockwise direction, so when the clock rotates in the crank rotates in the clockwise direction, the connecting rod link should be pushed to the other end of the crank, and the lever connected to the connecting rod comes to the downward position, and lifting is done with the piston and piston rod. So ikkada lever ki second position lo, so manaki other end lo em chestunna ante oka piston ni fix chestunnanamma. So piston ni fix chesi oka cylinder lo danni fix chestunnanu manu. Idi piston rod, this is the piston. So piston moves upward direction and on downward direction, so it is on the reciprocating motion here. So when the crank rotates in the different positions, so when the crank point rotates in different positions, the lever goes from upward and downward in direction. So it is used to oscillate. So you can see it in the picture also. The lever is going to oscillate, and when the oscillation is done, the other end of the lever is connected to the piston rod and to the piston. So the piston rod also moves on from upward and downward movement, that is the reciprocating movement. So here the motion travels from rotary motion to the reciprocating motion. So this beam engine transmits the motion from rotary motion to reciprocating motion. Rotary motion from the reciprocating motion. Here we use to explain the beam engine as from explaining the links. So here first link is the fixed link, that is the base of the beam engine to the lever, and second link is the crank position. Here we are taking it as the second link. Third link is the connecting rod which connects the crank to the lever, and fourth link is the lever which is connected to the piston rod from the other end. So these are the different types of links, and the mechanism evaluated from the beam engine mechanism is it transmits the motion from rotary motion to the reciprocating motion. So that is the basic concept of the beam engine. So it is used to transmit motion from rotary motion to the reciprocating motion. Reciprocating motion anna linear motion anna okate namma rendu. So there is no difference between the linear motion and reciprocating motion. Both the motions are different in their segment. So rendu kuda straight ga move avutame. So manaku edaithe oka part untadu, machine oka part untadu, lekapothe oka member untadu. Aa member anedi straight ga move ayye position ni manam reciprocating motion gaani linear motion gaani antnam ikkada. So that is the main position here. So let's see the working of these beam engine in an animated source through video. So we can see it in the video. So let's see the animation of the beam engine mechanism. So this is the beam engine 3D part. The beam engine 3D part. So this is the fixed link here which we can take the base of the lever, and second one it is the crank. So crank means it is a wheel position. So in the crank a position is fixed and it is connected to the connecting rod, and this connecting rod is connected to the lever at one end, and the other end of the lever is connected to the piston rod and to the piston. So you can see the parts clearly here. So this is the piston, and this is the cylinder with cuff section, that is the cutting section of the inner part, and this is the connecting rod, lever with support, and first connecting rod, crank. So this is the basic parts of the beam engine. This is the assembly of the beam engine. So this is the working. So you can see the piston moving
from the forward and backward direction.
So when the crank is rotating in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, so it also oscillates the lever. So it will oscillate the lever, and the other end of the lever is connected to the piston, and the piston is moving according to the speed of the crank. You can see it in the picture also, the working of beam engine. So it is in the slow movement. This is the basic working of the engine. one student asked for one more time of the video representation of the mechanism. So you can see it in a picture, when the crank rotates it with full speed, the piston or the piston rod oscillates in the upward and downward motion. So you can see it in the animated part. The lever oscillates in the two directions, that is in the downward and upward direction. So this is the slow movement of the beam engine. So you can see it clearly here. So that is the beam engine which transmits the motion from rotary motion to the reciprocating motion. So that is the beam engine. So next one is the coupled rod of a locomotive. So you can see the picture here. So there are two cranks. So it is also called as double crank mechanism also. So there are four links in this coupling rod of a locomotive. So AD and BC are the parallel links. So AB and BC are parallel to each other. and AD are parallel to each other.
Basic function of a coupling rod of a locomotive. This mechanism can be seen in locomotive, that is in the train engine. So engine train engine lo ekkuva chustunnam manam front wheel rendu kuda attach chesintaru connecting rod toti ok pedda metal bar toti so dani connecting rod anukuntunnam. So first wheel manaku rotate avvali, second wheel kuda automatic ga tho paatu rotate avuta untundannamata. So atlanti position unna mechanism kosam kuda manam coupling rod of a locomotive ni iskovachu. So ikkada endante AB DC అనేది రెండు parallel links మనకి. So AB DC అనేది మనకి రెండు parallel links. Next BC AD కూడా రెండు parallel links. వాటిని cranks అనుకుంటాం. ఇక్కడ AD BC అనే వాటిని రెండింటిని కూడా cranks అనుకుంటాం. రెండు cranks వల్ల మనం ఏమవుతుందంటే CD అనేది కనెక్టింగ్ రాడ్ గా పరిగణిస్తాం మనకి. సో ఎప్పుడైతే AD అనేది క్లాక్ వైస్ లో గానీ యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైస్ లో గానీ రొటేట్ అవుతుందో మనకి దాని కనెక్టివిటీ ఉన్న CD కనెక్టింగ్ రాడ్ కూడా మనకి BC ని రొటేట్ చేస్తుంది అన్నమాట. సో BC ఇస్ ఆల్సో యూజ్డ్ టు రొటేట్ ఇన్ ది సేమ్ డైరెక్షన్. సో మనకి AD అనేది క్లాక్ వైస్ లో తిరిగితే BC కూడా క్లాక్ వైజ్ లో తిరుగుతుంది. AD అనేది యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైజ్ లో తిరిగితే BC కూడా యాంటీ క్లాక్ వైజ్ డైరెక్షన్ లో మూవ్ అవుతుంది. సో అట్లా మనకి ఈ మెకానిజం అనేది మోషన్ ని ట్రాన్స్మిట్ చేస్తుందమ్మా. సో ద మెయిన్ ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ మెకానిజం ఇస్ టు ట్రాన్స్మిట్ మోషన్ ఫ్రమ్ రోటరీ మోషన్ టు రోటరీ మోషన్. సో ఒక రోటరీ మోషన్ నుంచి ఇంకో రోటరీ మోషన్ లోకి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ చేస్తుంది అన్నమాట మనకి. మనం ఇప్పుడు ఒక యానిమేషన్ చూద్దాం దీన్ని కూడా. Equal diameter crank. So you can see it in the picture also. So rotor diameter crank. So both cranks are connected by the rod which is called as connecting rod. This is the assembly of all the parts. You can see it in the multiple directions. These two yellowish parts, yellowish surface is called as crank. is the working of this mechanism. So this can be rotated in the clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, and this mechanism is mainly used for transmitting 1 wheel motion to the other wheel. So the main object is to rotate motion from one wheel to other, and its motion for both wheels remains same direction. The application are so as explained in the previous slide. This is the locomotive of the train. So train is now used as motion from one wheel to the other. So this is about the coupling rod of a locomotive. The double crank mechanism is one of the two cranks. So two cranks can be used. No, the two cranks are okay. Connecting rod are much better. So the there is no change in this one. So here we are using the two cranks. In the earlier mechanism, we have used only one crank, one connecting rod, and one lever and fixed link. But here we are using two lever cranks, one fixed link, and one connecting rod. Inversion. So in the first inversion we have seen the beam engine, and this is the second inversion, that is the coupling rod of a locomotive. And in the third inversion it is watch indicator mechanism. We can see it in the later video lecture, the next video lecture. And this is the last one, this is four part chain mechanism, that is quarter chain cycle mechanism. First of all, in these two mechanisms, we have to explain the diagram. So what are the links and what are the existing links, and what are the names of these links. So by constructioning the diagram, first diagram construction is called. So diagram need to be explained. After links, there is only a link. Motani koda explain here. So what are the links available in this mechanism, and what is the function of this mechanism. So in mechanism, I need to use the so what is the objective? So mechanism of objective. So engine. So it is used to transmit motion from rotary to rotary. But in the previous mechanism, the first inversion of the beam engine, the objective is to transmit the motion from rotary to reciprocating motion. So that is far different from the first one. And in the coupling rod of a locomotive, it is used to transmit rotary from to rotary motion. That is the basic difference there. So diagram is the link next by space next to object only functioning entity attractive use for application. So that's all for the two inversion. And in the later class we use it to see the third inversion of the four bar chain mechanism.